What is going on, guys? We are back with more Snake Draft, and we got Kick-Ass versus Tama homie. We're just gonna rewatch the first a few turns. He goes for Flamethrower on the land of turn one. Not sure what he predicted there, because Flamethrower only hit the Majorna, and why would you go Majorna on a Celesteela? I don't know, that was a bit weird. But yeah, he goes into the Reuniclus on the Clef and fires off a Psyshock. This Reuniclus, if it has Speed Creep for the Toxapex and it has Calm Mind, it's gonna be pretty scary. So we see some Megalodies. Jubilee just gonna go for Defog here. We see this leftover Zygarde, so it's probably sub DD. Makes a lot of sense with the Toxapex, Toxic Spike support from Toxapex. So he goes for Recover. I thought he would go for Defog. So yeah, he cannot stay in. You see it's Volt Switch Mijuna, so that now we find out already that it's probably gonna be Assault Vest. So he's gonna go for Protect here, he's going to get some leftovers with his Celesteela. You see that Terrakion or the Greninja is gonna be Scarfa on Kick-Ass's team, and the Bulu is probably gonna be the Zemofuser, but we don't know that yet. It could also be the Reuniclus. We don't know yet if it's lefty, so Zemove, we shall see that later. So he gets a Discharge Para on the Lardy, so we will shall see. He gets full Para there. That sucks, so he doesn't get the Defog off. Now he can just keep spamming Volt Switch, and the Celesteela is getting chipped down. The Celesteela is like mixed defensive because the Volt Switch is doing a really good amount. It's like a bit more fist def, I think. And Tama homie could double here, breaking the Lardy. Yeah, he goes in the Clef on the predicted Lardy. It's a nice play. So like, if Kick-Ass had stayed in there, it would have been a really good play, but he didn't. Like, it was just pretty obvious that the Lardy would come out, and Tama homie's play makes sense because he doesn't want to give it the free defog. He gets another para and the Lardy dies. Because if Kick-Ass spams Recover, there's a chance that he gets paralyzed again, so he just wants to get rid of the rocks. But yeah, those two paralyzed already sucked. So there's the common Reuniclus. The Zygarde is not Bennett, it's a DD sub 1000 arrows, I assume. And there's a Z-move, it's a Corkscrew Crash. So this set is used mainly to beat Unaware Clefable on stall. And 1000 arrows does absolutely nothing at plus 1. I assume this Reuniclus is... I mean, it's obviously defensive, but... It might even be max defense because they took absolutely nothing from that. So yeah, Tama homie doesn't have anything to beat this at this point. He's gonna have to sack this probably, or... This is a potential recover for Kick-Ass, so I would just spam 1000 arrows here. Or DD again is a good play here. Yeah, DD again is a nice play so that you do a little bit more damage. Because if you just T-Arrows, he's gonna be able to recover that off easily. So, if Tama homie's Lando, but looking at Tama homie's team, it should be Scarf Lando in my opinion, because his team is like pretty slow. I mean, he has a balanced core, like it's a bulky core, Pex, AV, Majorna, Clef is probably gonna be fist def to switch into Bandit, Zygarde, or the check Zygarde in general. Check Midi Chim and stuff like that. And then he has a Zapdos, so like there's already like a lot of defensive ones and like some speed control, like. Scarf Lando would make a lot of sense on this team, but yeah, if he Z-move Lando, that would be like his main way to pressure the Reuniclus. After he sacks something, he can go to Lando and go for Z-move. I don't know, I don't see how else he can beat this Reuniclus unless he has a Speed Creep on his Toxapex to haze it before it attacks, but even then Psyshock is still gonna do around 60%, I would assume, 60 to 70. But yeah, I would just go for a DD here from Tama homie, like I said. He goes for Protect, I don't like that play. And Kick-Ass just goes for Recover and gets 3 Reuniclus back to full. So now you can just click Psyshock and eat up a 1000 arrows. Oh, that didn't kill, okay. I mean, Kick-Ass can just recover again. I don't know why he's not going for Dragon Dance. Because, like, you're not doing any damage if you just attack. He recovers again, predicting the Protect, so Kick-Ass gets him there. But since he doesn't have lefties on the Reuniclus, he also kind of wasted the recover BP. Like, I know that he wants to be as healthy as possible, I understand that, but he also has to be kind of careful that he doesn't waste his recover, because his Mon kind of just wins. Now, I think that was a fun play, yeah. So now, Tama homie, if he's Z-move Lando, he can go to that and scare it out, and if he's not Z-move Lando, like, he should be Scarf Lando on this team. But if he's for some reason Z-move Lando, he could, he could bluff that at least. His other only play would be going into Zapdos and fishing for Discharge Paras, or hoping that his Pex is fast and hazing. But I assume if it's Lando, it's not Zemo, we should go into Zap doesn't just fish for discharge paras. Because like if you go into Jonah, you have to bank on crits, that's only a 6% chance, 6.25, and para chance is at least... Was it 30% with discharge? I think it was 30%, right? Then you can hope for Hex, and if he's parried, Toxapex outspeeds the Uniclus, and can then haze it later on, which is gonna be nice. Yeah. I mean, he also got some discharge luck, he already got some discharge luck on the Laddy, if you can repeat that. That's like his way out here, which obviously sucks, because like it shows that Mons, sometimes Mons is just... I don't know, like, I like Mons a lot, but sometimes it's just not that competitive in my opinion, but there's these percent chances where you can just luck through. I mean, I'm pretty sure he doesn't have speed on his Toxapex, the speed creep Uniclus that speed creeps Toxapex, because otherwise he would have potentially already gone out into, probably already gone out in Toxapex and clicked Haze. So I'm pretty sure we're gonna see the Lando slash Zapdos. And yeah, later on my channel, I will have Vertex versus Comp, the ulti losers bracket round 2. That game was like yesterday, but was at 4 AM or something, so I was too tired, so I have to re-narrate that game. Yeah, you can guess and stay tuned for that. So he finally goes into Pex. I mean, Pex can probably take a hit, but I don't know. This is gonna do a lot. That's 73, okay. I thought it would do a bit more even. So I assume this Toxapex has some sort of fifth dev investment, which makes a lot of sense if you look at Tamahome's team. Or Tamahome, however you pronounce him. Because he has a Solvus Majuna, so it's always a special bulk on that side. So this makes sense that this is more fifth dev. But it's probably mixed defensive anyways. I mean, now he's forced out unless he wants to sack his packs. Okay, guess I can just go for Calm Mind here, right? Oh, he can even go for Recover, but I think he will Calm Mind. If the Lando is Scarf, like Earthquake does around, I think 30%, maybe a bit more. But yeah, we don't know that yet. I mean, we have seen teams like this a lot, also in World Cup. Like, not similar teams, but like, with like, kind of the same month, but like, Clef and Pex, and then the Lando was most of the time just Scarf, and it just makes sense that the Lando should be Scarf on this team. But yeah, Command or Recover both are fine plays here. I think Command is fine. Tamo might go into Majuna to get a slow Volt Switch. Is Majuna slower? Majuna's probably faster from Uniclus. Uniclus is really slow. He goes hard into Landorus, so maybe he is the move. We shall see that now, but if he could also just click Earthquake first to try and bring his unwrench from Z-move, but I don't know. The same Reuniclus one from the start in the chat. So he just goes for... That's definitely... I think that's Jolly damage, right? 37%. And he can just recover spam here. He doesn't seem to have a Z-move, because he would have gone for a Z-move if he had it. So he's just Scarf. Or is he Scarf? I don't know if he's Scarf Lando, we don't know it confirmed yet, but he should be looking at team. Like I said this multiple times now. But yeah, Kegathas was out of range from a crit, so Calm Mining again was a fine play. But you know, he's just gonna recover again because he shouldn't risk this. Yeah, exactly, that's a fine play. And now he can just Calm Mind like two more times, and he can just... Now he has to recover again. But like, if he's at plus 3 or plus 4, he can just start spamming Psyshock. I don't know, does he need plus 6? Oh, we see the roads are like this between 32 and 37. So Tamahome is getting some low roads there. But yeah, if he does this not Z-move Lando, then he has to just go into Zapdos and fish for paras. Not sure why he didn't do that before. Very uniqueless? It's actually somewhat scary in a lot of games where it's brought. The last time I've seen it was an ulti round one from Haye. Oh, I still don't know how to pronounce him. But yeah, it also put on work in that game. He also brought it in round two, but I didn't see that match live, so I don't know if it put in work. But I know he lost that match and there was some hacks against him. So he finally decides to go and zap this because he sees that his Lando just... Unicus just sets up on his Lando, so like... This is his only win con just to get the para. And we shall see if he gets it. He gets it first try, that sucks a lot, and he gets a full para right after. So now the Toxapex outspeeds. He gets another para, he's getting all the luck. What the fuck is this? So now if I'm kick-ether here, I would probably click Psyshock. He could also click Recover, but if the Pex comes out here, he can click Haze. Pex should definitely outspeed with the para, even though para got nerfed. Oh my fucking god, what is this luck? Like, this is... Oh my... If he Psyshocked there, that sucks so much. If he really Psyshocked there, I don't know if he Psyshocked or recovered, obviously. But now he can just Haze, and Unicus doesn't win anymore because the boosts are gone, because Pax outspeeds it now. And yeah, this is stupid. Like, if this would happen to me in a tournament game, I would just... Like, I don't know. I would probably not play the game for a few days. It's, he's stupid. And yeah, now this Pax gets away and can go for recover here. Sucks. Okay, so I got interrupted real quick. I'll just tell you guys what happened. So he went for command with this Reuniclus, forcing the Pax to go for Haze, and then he used his free turn that he got and got went into his Bulu on the Haze, so he doesn't have to fear the Toxapex going for Scald. And then he sets up a sub so the Pax can burn him, then he sets up SD on the switch, and the Landris does reveal that its HP is, and the Bulu is faster, so the Lander wasn't Scarf after all, which is really weird. And now he goes into Zapdos and gets a crit, and that sucks a lot. Nothing is going Kick-Ether's way. I would probably just forfeit the game here. This is just some bullshit. Like, what is this? So it's Terrakion, we don't know the set yet. It's could definitely be Z-move. This is the only potential rocker, and he does just throw up the rocks. As we've seen, this Lando is probably defensive because it showed HPS and was slower than the Bulu. What? This is so weird. So he doesn't have a Scarf on this team. Really interesting. So the Celesteela is gonna come out here, or the Reuniclus. I think the Celesteela is around 30%, but it's defensive Lando, so Celesteela can still switch in. He goes hard on the Greninja, so potentially predicting... I don't know what he predicted. Potentially predicting HP Ice. If this is extra sensory, like Life Orb, that would be really cool for him, but it's probably not the way he played it. So like, it kind of makes me think that it's Scarf Brand. He just didn't go for a move to not reveal his set. There's another para just to rub some salt in a wound. It's, yeah, the T-Spike that Tamahome got up is also really nice for him to chip at the Grenade at the Tarak. And yeah, Kick-Ether's Hazard Control is dead. But yeah, again, a really nice play going for Calm Mind, forcing the Pex to go for Haze and then using that free turn to go into Celesteela, like knowing that he's not going to go for Scald. He's definitely gonna go for Haze when the unit's at plus one. Then he gets a free switch into Celesteela, gets more health on that. But I don't think it matters. Like, now that Terrakion and the Grin are getting chipped, like I said, from the T-Spike. And Zapdos also has pressure, so like this Leech Seed game is not gonna happen forever. He also has like Pex to always like... Pex plus Zapdos just easily stalls out Celesteela's PP. So the stone is just 24, so I'm pretty sure that's just... regular damage, no choice band, like just regular Terrakion damage. So he gets in the Celesteela and the Earthquake. But like I said, the Celesteela is not a threat to Tamahome, even if it gets healthy again. He doesn't really care about that. And Zapdos can just go for Roost here. Even Discharge is fine, like not that it really matters. If he discharges here, this game is over, but he just roosts. So he's Kick-Ether threatens this with an Ice Beam. But he can just go into Toxapex slash Majorna. Yeah, Majorna is actually a fine play. And he can just Volt Switch here. Now he can go back to Zapdos and Roost. Or he can go into Pex and fish for a burn, but yeah, he just goes Zapdos. Now he can just spam Discharge. So Kick-Ass goes for Protect to stall out 1 PP, but it doesn't really help him that much. Like, this game is just over. I understand that he's still playing, obviously, but yeah, this is just really frustrating. So he stays in even to go for a lead sheet, but he already used, I think, 3 lead sheets or something on his Zapdos, so that's already 6 lead sheet PP gone. And now he didn't even go for Protect to get more health back. Yeah, if the Rhinocus wasn't paralyzed, it just won. So, like, even now it would still win if it wasn't paralyzed, but yeah. He doesn't have any sort of, like, cleric on his team, like Heal Bell. And yeah. So it's Spikes, Ash, Grind, that's probably Specs. Yeah, some. Did the Terrakion change up moves? I actually don't remember if it did. Thinking the Terrakion is Scarf, though. Because we know now that the Grin is, Ash Specs, most likely. Like, we don't all confirm that it's Specs, but it's definitely Ash, that's what we know. Battlebond is what I meant to say. So yeah, again, he keeps making that play of going for Calmind and forcing the Pecs to go for Haze, but it doesn't really matter. Like, how does Kick-Ass even break anything at this point? And his entire team is just getting chipped. Like, not his entire team, but the Terrakion and the Grin get chipped by T-Spikes, and the Rhinocus just doesn't win anymore because it's paired. Kick-Ass have bricked the Majorna there, that's why he Hydro Pumped. Because it's obviously AV Majorna. And Tamahome, like, he assumed that Tamahome didn't want to risk the Pecs getting flinched. And like, he just doesn't have anything to pressure. Like, the monster that don't get chipped, the Rhinocus and the Celestia, they just can't win. Celestia will get easily slaughtered off PP, and Rhinocus is kept in check by the para, and Haze obviously has more PP than Calmind. That's also something that is that helps Tamahome here a lot. So he's gonna go for recover here, obviously, with the Toxapex. And now he can just go back into Zapdos. He can even go into Clef on the lead sheet. But he doesn't have to risk it, obviously. But yeah, that would have been a nice play, going into Clef and pivoting into Zapdos. But no need to risk anything. And if you're Tamahome, you can just play safe. Default gets rid of the hazard, so like, now he's not even getting annoyed by that anymore. So like, his Solvus Majorna doesn't get chipped, and his Pecs can just regenerate off in peace. And yeah, he just gets the rocks back. Like, he can just go for like a U-turn off quick, it doesn't really matter. Like, he doubles back, but he didn't have to make that play. Like, that was a nice play, because now he can roost up. But he didn't have to make that play. So Kick-Ass are like doubles and all that, everything's like he tries, but like, he just can't win. So like, Tamahome says GG. I think I'm behind, actually. They're playing fast. And I'm also watching this on slow internet because my fast internet died. Like, a few minutes before the game, my fast internet died. It was really annoying. Also before the ABM Brofist game. Like, this is right after the ABM Brofist game. But yeah, the game is over, basically. Kick-Assa doesn't say GG back, and Pearl is like, why are you not saying GG, and Pearl says GG for Kick-Assa. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed. This was kind of a shitty game, not gonna lie, the hacks sucked a lot. And yeah, you can expect the next upload to be like an old C-Series Vertex game. I mentioned this already, that I have to re-narrate that, because it was at like 4 AM my time, and I was too tired to live narrate. So stay tuned for that, hope you all enjoy, have a fantastic day, and goodbye. Yeah, this is just Pokemon. I'm pretty sure a lot of you guys have had moments like this where you just don't want to play this game anymore because of hacks. Yeah, peace out.